time to make sure that your cell phones are turned off and that your candy is unwrapped. Also, please be advised that the taking of photographs or the use of recording devices of any kind in this theater is strictly prohibited by law. Thank you.
Very well, I'll tell you. for a woman to bear a child, she must. As she can love only him.
Only him.
She must love with her whole heart. There, now you know everything.
Everything?
Everything, so help me.
Mama!
Mama who bore me, Mama who gave me, Mama the angels who made me so sad.
Erebor?
operating together with Melky or before. Nobody operating. Waiting.
Vikra, Motun, Ibe. Estes, Yatachus, and Alto. Is it bad? Satellite, nothing more. They've known it's
for the tunnel. History and science. Over the road, at school, at home, by the blind men. You doubt them, and soon they bark and hound you. Till everything you say is just another bad about you. All they say is trusting what is written. Words are made, and somehow that is wisdom. Thought is suspect, and money is their idol, and nothing is okay.
Oh.
nasty in those khakis. Got my whole life like some test.
Then there's Maria Whelan. As if she'd return my call. I was like, just kiss some ass, man. But you can't screw up my own.
Sanctuary in orchids and chrysanthemums.
not so wonderful as that sad, soulful, sleepyhead Moritz Stiefel.
Moritz Stiefel? How can you even compare them?
Melky the Moor. He's such a radical.
He doesn't believe in anything. Not in God, not in heaven, not in a single thing in this world. They say he's the best in everything. Latin, Greek, trigonometry, the best it is. He doesn't care a whit about any of it.
And as well as nothing, this mess of life, still there's this one just to see you go by. It's almost like nothing, sad as that is. May not be cool, but it's so weird. It's like I'm your lover, or more like your ghost. I spend the day wondering what you do, where you go. Try and just kick it, but then what can I do? We've all got our junk, and my junk is you.
I take your murder lightly. The truth is I can hardly bear to think of the long nights ahead. But it's sucking the marrow from my bones. Seeing you lie there, motionless, staring at me so innocently. One of us must go. It's you or me.
No, no! Get it on, please, again! And this time, bring out the left.
Darling, why? Why do you press your knees together even now on the brink of eternity? Don't you see? It's your terrible chastity that's driving me to my
own charm! That's enough in there!
Yes, sir.
Back to bed! Son!
1 minute. One last kiss. Those soft red eyes. Those girlish breasts. Those cruel, cruel knees.
Liberty, s'il vous plaît!
Well, you have to excuse me. I know it's so hard. I know I can't do this. Stop that truth is so wrong. I can walk to my room, turn the stereo on, and shoot up some you in the USA.
Give all the action, all got our junk. Get out of my junk, is you. Does the mayor feel shame as she couples with a stallion? Are they deaf to everything their loins are telling them until we grant them a marriage certificate? I think not. To my mind, shame is nothing but a product of education. Meanwhile, old Father Kaulbach still blindly insists in every single sermon that it's deeply rooted in our sinful human nature. Which is why I now refuse to go to church.
Melchior?
Yes, Mama?
Moritz Stiefel to see you.
Moritz! Sorry I'm so late.
I yanked on a jacket, ran a brush through my hair, and dashed like some phantom to get here.
You slept through the day?
I'm exhausted, Melky. I was up till 3 in the morning reading that essay you gave me until I couldn't see straight.
Shit! Let me roll you a smoke. Look at me.
I'm trembling. Last night, I prayed like Christ in Gethsemane. Please, God, give me consumption and take these sticky dreams away from me.
With any luck, he'll ignore that prayer.
Melky, I can't focus on anything, even now. It seems like, well, I see and hear and feel quite clearly. And yet everything seems so strange.
But all those illustrations I gave you, didn't they help illuminate your dreams?
They only multiply everything 10 times! Instead of merely seeing stockings, now I am plagued by labia majora.
Herr Stiefel, how are you?
Very well, thank you.
Yes?
Just think, Mama. Moritz was up reading all through the night!
Conjugating Greek.
You must take care of yourself, Moritz. Surely your health is more important than ancient Greek. Now, what have you been reading, Melchior?
You're just fast up to me.
Really? At your age?
So beautiful, Mama.
So haunting.
Still, I should have thought. But surely you boys are now of an age to decide for yourselves what is good for you and what is not. Well, if you need anything else, children, call me.
Well, your mother certainly is remarkable.
Until she catches her son reading Goethe.
I think she meant the story of Gretchen and her illegitimate child.
Yes. You see how obsessively everyone fixes on that story? It's as if the entire world were mesmerized by penis and vagina.
Well, I am. All the more so, I'm afraid, since reading your essay. What you wrote about the female... I can't stop thinking about it. This part. Here. Is it true?
Absolutely.
But how can you understand that, Melky? What the woman must feel.
Giving yourself over to someone else? Defending yourself? Until finally you surrender and feel heaven break over you? And imagine.
Really? Imagine what it feels like for the woman.
Where I go, there, no more memory anymore. Only drifting on some ship. When the whispers at the distance to shore. When I go there, no more listening anymore. Only hymns upon your lips, a mystic wisdom rising with them.
must admit, with all the different genitalia. It truly is daunting. I mean, how everything might
measure up. Fit. More smell than I'm saying I myself have ever.
Not that I'm saying I wouldn't want.
Whatever.
Once
do I have to go?
It's boys, wait!
Morris.
Elkio, what is
nothing.
Has Moritz gone?
Yes.
Well, he does look awfully pale, don't you think? I wonder, is that Faust really the best thing for him?
Together. Wouldn't that be remarkable?
when you lean back against this oak and stare up at the clouds, you start to think hypnotic things.
You have to be back before 5.
When you lie here, such a strange, wonderful peace settles over you.
Now that that skittish, you're a phasic moron.
Moron's hateful.
Has somehow passed our midterm exams. It would appear we face a certain dilemma. The upper grade, as we know, will hold only 60. I hardly think we can promote 61.
Hardly, Captain Ottenbrock. But let us look to the finals ahead.
Yes.
Remember, it is I who shall be marking them.
But I assure you, the good name of our school is secure.
Shall we take the short way?
No, no. Why the frick? After 2 hours marching with that medicine ball? Come on, the moon wants to see.
Thank you.
parentocracy in secondary education.
Herr Stiegel, may we have a word with you?
A word for teachers, like parents, view us as merely so much raw material for an obedient and productive society. A unified, military-like body where all that is weak must be hammered away. Where the progress of the students reflects back only on the rank and order of the faculty. And therefore, a single low mark can be seen as a threat.
Now, here. So I met a streamer when I saw you here.
Yes.
So,
streamer, hearing me again?
was wondering, hypothetically speaking, what would happen if...
If
one day I failed. Not that I'm saying any.
You failed?
No. No.
You failed, I can see it on your face.
Father, no, Father, please!
Well, it's finally come to this. I can't say I'm surprised. Failed. So now, what are your mother and I supposed to do? You tell me, son. What? How can she show her face? What do I tell them at the bank? How do we go to church? What do we say? My son failed. Failed. Thank God my father never lived to see this day.
Dear Herr Stiefel. Moritz. I've spent the entire day thinking about your note. Truly it touched me that you think of me as a friend. Of course, I was saddened to hear that your exams are being all friend less well than you hoped, and that you will not be promoted to the hall. And yet I must say straight away that fleeing to America is hardly the solution. And even if it were, I cannot provide the money you request.
The fun, not like it's even worth the time, but still you know you wanted more. Sorry it won't change the narrative.
Still I'll split it down.
her up? Where's Miguel?
Yes. Why?
Your friend from Chitipa is absent. Someone said he's been missing all day.
I expect he's had his fill of Michaelmas.
Perhaps. You know I have your journal. The other day, I confess I tried reading
quite... Just please.
Thank you.
to an adage much loved of Martin Luther. To God, to our parents, to our teachers, we can never render sufficient gratitude. How well we know these words may strike our modern ear as merely quaint, as dubious, as old. And yet, let us pose this question. Each of us, within our dark heart, in what ways have we honored or dishonored our father and mother? In what ways have we strayed, in soul, in body, from all the wise instruction of our clergymen, our teachers?
Just leaning over things and nothing. Ilsa? You frightened me.
Did you lose something?
Why did you frighten me, damn it?
What are you looking for?
If only I knew. So, where have you been keeping yourself?
Priapia. The Arts Club?
Yes.
All those old fuckers, Lawrence. All so bohemian. And all they want to do is dress me up and paint me. Well, that Johann Ferendorf, he's a wicked one, actually. Always knocking easels down and chasing me. Dabbing me with his paintbrush. But then that's men. If they can't stick you with one thing, they'll try another. Oh God, Lawrence! The other day we all got so drunk, I passed out in the snow. I just lay there unconscious all night. Then I spent an entire week with Gustav Lau. Truly, inhaling that ether of his. Until this morning when he woke me with a gun set against my breast. He said, "One twitch, and it's the end!" Then he gave me the goosebumps. But how about you, Warren, still in school?
This semester, I'm through.
Just wait in the sun through the afternoon, and then see.
book. The equations, remember?
Just for an hour.
I can't.
Well, walk me at least.
Honestly, I wish I could.
By the time you finally wake up, I'll be lying on some trash heap.
For the love of God, all I had to do was say yes. Ilsa! Ilsa!
Oh. mind, and how his dad had hoped he'd grow all the things he ever lived or left behind, all the fears that
really jump
is that the weirdest shit I've seen. You're just a fly. The little guys, they kill for fun.
Man, you're fucked, dude.
Blah, blah, blah.
to hide their envy. Trust me. There are only three ways a man can go. He can let the status quo defeat him, like Morris. He can rock the boat like Melchior and be expelled. Or he can bide his time and let the system work for him, like me. Think of the future as a pail of whole milk. One man sweats and stirs, turning into butter. Like Otto, for example. Another man frets and spills his milk and cries all night. Like Georg. But me? Well, I'm like a pussycat. I just skim off the cream. Just skim off the cream, right? What about the pudding? Watch it. Travel the world within my lips. Fondle the pearl of your distant dreams. Haven't you heard the word of your body? Oh, you're gonna be wounded. Oh,
you gotta be my moon. describing these since before you were born, young lady. In fact, I recently recommended them to the utterly exhausted young Baroness von Witzelben. 8 days later, I'm pleased to report, she's off to a spa in Pyrmont, breakfasting on roast chicken and new potatoes. So, my child, 3 a day, an hour before meals, in a few weeks you should be fine. Breakfasting on sucking pig, no doubt.
So that's all it is, Doctor. Anemia.
Set to.
And the nausea?
Not so. Uncommon. Trust me, child, you'll be fine. Frau Bergmann, I can have a word with you.
Certainly, Doctor.
Again, that bit of paradise.
Did I see that?
Yes, do have a look.
He's
essay shows, he knew the danger of doing it. And yet he went ahead, defiling himself, and all but destroying that girl. So you tell me, Fanny, what shall we do?
Thank you. church?
No. I will be waiting there at midnight. Of your more.
He hasn't heard. Waiting for Vendula.
Poor Melchior. Poor Vendula.
Bye.
arm through the distant night, and I won't let them stray from my heart. Through the wind, through the dark, through the winter light, I will read all their dreams through the stars. I'll walk now with them.
families
and
the audience.
But more importantly, our family, every cast member.